بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. In the name of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, most gracious, most merciful. الحمد لله. All praise is indeed due to Allah سبحانه وتعالى. والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Blessings and salutations upon Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, his entire household, his companions. May Allah bless them all. May Allah bless every one of us, and may Allah bless humanity at large. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us mercy in this beautiful month of Ramadan. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us from those who are granted freedom from hellfire and entry into Jannatul Firdaus. Ameen. My beloved brothers and sisters, it is absolutely important for us to realize that this month of Ramadan is a month wherein the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends onto the earth. And every single person is granted the mercy of Allah if he or she would like to achieve that mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this month of Ramadan is a month wherein every night there are names of people who are granted freedom from hellfire. So make your name from among those names by seeking the forgiveness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we are to ask Allah protection from hellfire thrice every day, hellfire itself asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from it. So it is amazing how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has granted us such a favor. If we were to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Jannatul Firdaus, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannah. Oh Allah, I ask you Jannah. If you repeat that three times every day, then Jannah itself asks Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give you Jannah. So you'd better say, Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannah. My beloved brothers and sisters, we are going to be speaking for the next hour about the deeds that we need to do in order to get paradise. We know that we would like goodness in this world and the next. The dua that we are taught in the Quran, رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. O our Rabb, grant us goodness in this world and grant us goodness in the next and save us from the fire or the punishment of the fire. That's a dua. It goes to show that what is important for you and I, we want a decent life on earth. And on top of that, we would like a decent death, and we would like that which is good in the hereafter. We also would like to be saved from the punishment in the grave, from the punishment of the hellfire. So we ask this to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but He taught us some simple things to do to earn Jannatul Firdaus. Remember, my brothers and sisters, Jannatul Firdaus is the paradise that belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He owns it, and He will decide what deeds you will do that will deserve entry into Jannah. But ultimately, it is His mercy, rahmatullahi azza wa jal, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that will actually make us enter into Jannatul Firdaus. This evening, mashallah, we fulfilled beautiful Salat al-Taraweeh. How do I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted it? I hope in His mercy because I tried my best, right? Sometimes the concentration span is not 100%. Sometimes we could have done better. Sometimes we have a small distraction. Yet this is salah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My brothers and sisters, your duty is to try your best. Then you ask Allah, رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ مِنَّا إِنَّكَ أَنْتَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. O our Rabb, accept it from us, for indeed you are all hearing, you are all knowledgeable. So my beloved brothers and sisters, the first reason or the first point that we would need to have within us in order to earn Jannatul Firdaus is al-Imanu Billah, to believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A person who does not believe in the hereafter, what do they want? There are people who believe that this is just the world. وَقَالُوا مَا هِيَ إِلَّا حَيَاتُنَا الدُّنْيَا نَمُوتُ وَنَحْيَا. They said, the kuffar of Quraysh, they used to say, it is only this worldly life. We're dying and we will be alive. That's it. There is nothing more than death and life. Nothing in the hereafter. For them, can they expect Jannah? Can they expect paradise when they did not believe in it? So to expect Jannatul Firdaus, we need to believe that after death, there is something indeed I will be taken account of. Al-Hisab. Everything is going to be taken account of.